Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to my channel. If you are new, my name is Meg, and today I am going to talk you through my denim collection. Now, in terms of this collection, this includes my jeans and one skirt and one pair of dungarees or overalls. Okay, I didn't include any of my denim shorts or dresses because that would take us forever to go through this one, to be honest. Here I have 13 pairs of jeans. One of them is wide leg, and a skirt, denim skirt, and in a little bit I'll be showing you the overalls as well. The overalls are by the brand Rolla, which I got secondhand from the shop Swap in Australia. They have an actual store, but they also are available online. So if you're looking for something secondhand that's like it's still good condition, then this would be a good place to start. So I've actually arranged these according to their brands and found that I do have quite a bit of Levi's, which isn't surprising because Levi's is probably like one of the best denim brands out there in terms of the variety that they offer, the quality of the actual fabric or material that they use. I have two pairs of Guess jeans, two pairs of Diesel jeans, two pairs of Armani jeans. How many Levi's? Three Levi's, one Jag skirt, one And Other Stories, one 7 For All Mankind, one Uniqlo, and one Esprit Decor. So let's go ahead and start with showing you these jeans. Now, I am wearing this sweater, which is also secondhand. I got it for like $8 at Vinnie's. It says Oxford University. I'll be using this top for all of the jeans, with the exception of the overalls, simply because that is a little bit more tight fitting, and it just wouldn't fit if I wore something as slouchy as these pair of sweaters. But overall, everything would remain the same. And the reason why I'm wearing this is because it's freezing today here in Sydney. I've got all of my winter clothes, one to reduce the noise and also two to keep the cold air out. Okay, I won't be pairing it with any shoes. I would just be wearing my fluffy socks for the winter. So let's proceed, and I'll start off with the Rolla dungarees. So these are my Rolla overalls. I got them from the Swap website, which is a second-hand website. They do have a shop on Enmore Road in Newtown, where it's actually quite close to the Enmore Theater. So this is very soft fabric. I'm not sure it's because it's already old or it's just really soft by itself, but I love the details in the pockets. These are my Jag denim skirt. I love the buttons. I got this from Mustard Seed Op Shop here in Piedmont. And they just really look nice, and I can't wait for the summer when I can wear them with my bare legs and not with fluffy socks like this, although it would look good with boots. Next, I've got here the Levi's jeans that's light wash. It's almost like gray, and I do like it. I got this from Vinnie's in, I believe this one is from the Glebe Vinnie's. And I love the details, the pockets and everything. It's even got a secret pocket inside the trousers. This is a pair of Levi's that I cuffed myself. This is their Slim Fit edition, and I got this from Birkenhead Point at their outlet shop. Okay, loving the fit of this, loving the rocker chic kind of vibe. And I do pair this with my Doc Martens. This one here is a pair of distressed Levi's jeans, and I got this as well from Birkenhead Point. I think I paid like something like $29 for this.
Now, they were originally a little bit too long for me, so what I did was cut off the hems and left it raw, so that it just gives it a little bit more of that distressed feel. I do love the look of this, especially with my Doc Martens boots or my Timberland ones. They really look nice. Then we've got here my Guess jeans, which I got from the outlet store at DFO in Homebush. These are the power stretch skinny jeans, and I do like how they are. So stretchy and so fitting, but you really need to wear thongs for this, otherwise your panties will show. This is followed by another pair of Guess jeans, which I got from TK Maxx, and they are really, really nice. Now, these were also originally quite long, so I cuffed them just above the ankles because I prefer to use these with my boots or with my low-cut Converse, the Chuck Taylor ones. So, loving the look of this one as well. Obviously, that's why I kept it. Here we've got my Diesel jeans. I've never actually worn these because these are a little bit tight, as you can see from the fit, around the crotch area and the hip area. But I'm pretty sure I can get this to work for me. I love the details, the pockets, and just how unique these are. It says it's 100% cotton, but I'm not so sure because it just feels weird. My favorite pair of denim jeans. These are by Diesel as well. They remind me so much of the 90s, which was the time when I was growing up, and I do love the fit. Both of my Diesel jeans are button fly, and I do prefer button flies over zips. And they just look beautiful. Just nice. Here we've got my first pair of Armani jeans. These are skinnies. They were quite long, so I hemmed them myself so that it falls right at the ankles, because I prefer these with my low-cut sneakers or some flats or even loafers when I want to look a little bit more polished. So yeah, loving the wash on these. Now, these ones are a darker version of my Armani jeans. Both my Armani jeans, by the way, are from TK Maxx. Now, this one feels a little bit like more like jeggings, and it feels warm, like almost like it's fleece lined inside. So even in the winter, I do love wearing this pair. Okay, now I've got my End Other Stories jeans. These are a little bit thicker than the material of the Guess jeans. I got this off of Vinny's in, I believe, and they were like $16 if I remember correctly. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. That's all I can say. This is my 7 for All Mankind pair of jeans. I got these from Vinny's at Roselle. Beautiful, my only pair of bootcut jeans, and they make my legs look a mile long when I wear them with heeled boots. So definitely something that I really like to wear. And then I've got here my Esprit de Corps pair of jeans. This is my only straight fit jeans. I do like these, especially when I feel like wearing a blazer as a third layer. They look really nice and very, very comfortable. Finally, we have my only pair of Uniqlo denims. I hear their denims are quite nice, but these are the only ones that I really like. These are wide leg, as you can tell, and high-waisted, so it's really unique in the shape.
And that is the entirety of my jeans, denim, long pants collection. And if you have any questions or comments about any of them, especially the ones that I hemmed myself or that I tweaked, okay, to fit me, then leave them in the comment section down below. And maybe, I guess, my takeaway for this is, if you are going thrift shopping and you don't see something that you like, or you see something that you like but it isn't quite as perfect as you want them to be, bear in mind that you could always get them altered to suit you. And while the cost of alteration may probably be more than the cost of the actual item that you are buying thrifted, it would still be cheaper than buying a brand new item. And plus, upcycling your garments and getting some more wear out of it is the more sustainable way to go. So that's it, I guess. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comment section down below, how many pairs of jeans do you actually own? And while this is very shameful for me to have all of these, I do love each and every one of them. But I am going to be downsizing my jeans and denim collection. In a few weeks, I'm going to be doing a Sydney suitcase rummage. There's one on August 25, and if there's one in September, I probably will be doing that as well. And whatever is not purchased during those weeks, I will be bringing home with me to Manila to give to my cousins and my aunts and the church that my mother frequents. Yeah. So they're not going to go into the bins, or they're not going to go unused. They will find a better home. If not with me, then elsewhere. All right? See you all again in the next video. I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't done so. Thank you. Bye.